Hi friends, so today we'll discuss about the STIs, that is the sexually transmitted infections. Last video we have talked about the various sexually transmitted organisms, and now we'll take some case scenarios and we'll discuss them. Because that was the approach of the next exam also, and obviously it is coming now in the NEET also in that particular fashion. And besides this, it will be helpful for the practical purpose also in your medical colleges. So guys, first of all, we'll talk about one other scenario, and you yourself try to guess up what it can be. So suppose a 25-year-old male is there. Okay, a 25-year-old male is there. That fellow have a history of frequent sexual contact. Okay, history of frequent sexual contact. Okay. Obviously, in them, it goes to the commercial sex workers also, and one day he get into the trap and develops what? Urethral discharge. Okay. There is a urethral discharge. Okay. And this particular urethral discharge is collected with the help of a swab, and it is sent to the microbiology lab. Now the question which come to your like practical exams and in your NEET or next can be what? That what might be the clinical diagnosis if this urethral discharge is coming off? Okay, what are the various etiological agents which can do it, and how will manage these types of cases? Simple enough. Okay, so one thing is for sure, that this is a like catch point here, the frequent sexual contact, obviously with the commercial sex workers and all, got a STD and develops what? Urethritis, and leads to this urethral discharge. Okay, so obviously you know that urethritis is of two types. One is gonococcal and one is NGU. One is gonococcal and one is what? NGU, non-gonococcal urethritis, right? Fine. So gonococcus, you already know that it's a gram-negative cocci. And NGU, the most common cause is what? Chlamydia trachomatis. So this is very clear to you. So this is one of the scenarios of the clinical case one. Now you got to see the another one, that is regarding the another history, and that particular history you take up like this. The second one is suppose a particular again a 32-year-old male is there. Okay. And that fellow is also having a history of frequent sexual contact. Frequent sexual contact. Okay. Then this particular one develops what? If the question says so, that that fellow develops what? Painless ulcer. Okay. And this painless ulcer is what? It's hard. Okay. It's a hard painless ulcer on the base of the penis. That particular fellow developed this hard painless ulcer on the base of the penis, and here you're able to get up the inguinal lymph nodes also. They are enlarged. Okay, they are enlarged, but interestingly this is also what? Painless. Okay, this is also what? Painless. So this particular thing suggests what? This particular thing suggests, obviously up till now, that it is going towards what? It is going towards the syphilis. Okay, it's going towards what? Syphilis, because these are the painless ones, and this is a painless hard ulcer which is there in this particular male which is 32 years old. Then that particular one can give you in the question that what is being sent of this particular fellow? Serum sample. So serum sample is being sent. Okay, or you can definitely you can send up the any particular discharge if it is coming off from that particular ulcer and all, which is not very common, but mainly in this what you do, you got out for the serum sample, and then the various tests are being done on that, and what is the etiological agents which are responsible for this ulcer formation and all, Okay, what are the various modalities you will go out? A favorite question of UG exam is this, that definitely there is a question regarding the lab diagnosis of syphilis. And you know that we mainly do two types of things there. One is non-treponemal test, which are VDR and RPR. And another one more sensitive and specific, that is the treponemal test. And those names also you know that they are there, that TPPA, TPI, TPHA, all that stuff. Okay, so we'll not go deep into that, but I will tell you how to approach up in the lab diagnosis for the sexually transmitted infections. Okay, and before starting off, let's have a table from Harrison, which is important also. And in this particular table, there is they have given up the difference between the various genital ulcers and all, and definitely one or two questions are there from that particular table. Okay, so firstly we'll talk about that particular table, and I suppose that will be helpful for you also. Okay, so suppose you take first of all, write up what we're reading first. We are reading this particular question first, that is the genital ulcers, the various features of them, genital ulcers. A damn sure question in your Viva also, and in your exam also, in the NEET PG or next, anywhere these types of questions will come. Okay, so syphilis first of all, then the second one you take up herpes. Okay, then you take up chancroid. Okay, and LGV, and one is what? Donovanosis. Okay, donovanosis. Fine. So basically, try to remember everything in a sequence. Okay, and if you go in a sequence, everything is damn easy. So first of all, if you talk about the incubation period, that is the IP. Okay, I sometimes write ICP also, that is also fine. So IP, incubation period. So remember like this, for syphilis it is 9 to 90 days. Okay, remember this, that is 9 to 90 days. So they're easy to remember for syphilis, that is 9 to 90 days. Regarding herpes, you remember up, it is 2 to 7 days. Herpes, that is 2 to 7 days, around a week. Okay, chancroid is variable and it can go between this 1 to 2 weeks, that is 1 to 14 days, that is chancroid. Lymphogranuloma venerum is LGV, which we told, like as the name is very big, so remember the incubation period is also very big. Some they write up 3 to 30 days, and sometimes it can go up to what? It can go up to 42 days also, so the highest time it takes. Fine, that is there, the LGV 3 to 30, and some books they write 3 to 42 also. Okay guys, now besides this, donovanosis as such, dono is having how much? 4 alphabets. So remember like this, 1 to 4 weeks, it is having what? 1 to 4 weeks, and it can go up to what? This can also go up to months together, but you just remember a 1 to 4 weeks, which is being asked also. So LGV was a All India question, so you need to remember the name and the incubation period of it. And incubation period is how much, guys? The incubation period is 3 to 30 days, okay? And it can extend to how much? It can extend to 42 days also. Okay, so firstly, we have discussed regarding the incubation period. Then we have the second thing, that how many lesions are seen up? Okay, how many lesions? What is the number of lesions which we observe up in all these particular fellows? Number of lesions. So remember, in syphilis, syphilis is the oldest sexually transmitted infection identified. So in this, it is usually one. Okay, it is usually one in this particular syphilis. Herpes, it is multiple. Okay, herpes, it is multiple. Chancroid, again it is multiple, usually multiple. Okay, this one is usually one. LGV is one. Okay, so big things are less only to one, and it can be multiple or it can be one also. That is a variable one. Which one? Donovanosis. Okay, so guys who don't know that these diseases are caused by what? Okay, those particular second year students. So let me tell you that this is easy to remember: syphilis, treponema pallidum, herpes. You know that herpes simplex virus is there. Herpes simplex virus 2 mostly causes what? These particular genital infections. So HSV2, that is herpes simplex virus. Chancroid is done by Haemophilus ducreyi, that you already know. And LGV, lymphogranuloma venereum, that is being done by what? It is done by Chlamydia trachomatis, L1, L2, L3. And which particular one more? L2. Okay. Then you have this donovanosis, and it is being done by what? It is being done by Klebsiella granulomatis, okay, which is also termed as what? Calimetobacter granulomatis. Okay, so these all things you need to remember. And another name is what? Donovanosis, also termed as what? Granuloma inguinal. Okay guys, so number of lesions, so basically one is here, okay. Syphilis and LGV, they have one, but herpes and chancroid, they have multiple. Now coming to the edges, if somebody asks you regarding the edges, in the edges you take like this. In this, the edges are very good demarcated, so that particular word is what? Sharply demarcated. It is sharply demarcated in the case of syphilis. Okay, the edges, and they are elevated. Remember, this particular thing is elevated. Whereas in the case of herpes, this particular edges, they are red, and that is termed as what? Erythematous. That particular thing is termed as what? Erythematous. And chancroid is a different one. This is undermined. This particular thing is termed as what? Undermined. You must have read in the surgery what is undermined also. So this is not elevated, this is undermined, and this is irregular also. Then LGV again is what? LGV is behaving like syphilis, so it is also elevated. Okay, it is also elevated, and it like, if you see now, there is usually one number of lesions here, also one. It is elevated, this is also elevated, this is round. Okay, sometimes it is round and all, and this is also round, so like that. Okay, and donovanosis also behaves like these only, and this is also elevated. So the point to be remembered is that which one is having undermined stuff. So undermined stuff is chancroid. Okay, this is having the undermined, ragged, irregular edges. Okay, these are the edges which you are talking about. Then if we talk about the depth, okay, if we talk about the depth of the ulcer, in the depth of the ulcer you go here, so it can be superficial. Okay, it can be superficial or it can be deep also. Superficial or deep. Whereas in the herpes, it is mostly the superficial one. It is mostly the superficial one. In this, it suggests like excavated. Okay, excavated. So means like in Hindi you call it khodna. So excavation. So excavated in this particular one is there. They're superficial or deep. Okay, again it is behaving like what? Syphilis one. So lymphogranuloma venereum, syphilis, they go hand in hand. And in this particular one, it is the depth also somewhat elevated. Okay, so depth is somewhat elevated in the case of donovanosis. Fine. Now let's see regarding the base. Okay, after the depth we'll talk about the base of that particular ulcer. Okay, so this one is smooth, this is non-purulent. Remember this particular thing, that this is non-purulent and this is non-vascular. Okay, smooth, non-purulent and non-vascular, that is seen in what? Syphilis. Whereas in the case of herpes, that is I've already told you that the edges are erythematous and the base is also what? Red one, that is the erythematous. And this one is non-vascular, okay? So it does not like bleeds and all. That is what is the meaning of it, okay? Chancroid. Now the third one is what of ours? That is the chancroid. And the chancroid is purulent. And this particular fellow bleeds easily, okay? This particular one, what? It bleeds easily, fine. And that's why it is also termed as what? Soft sore, okay? So this particular fellow is soft and it purulent and it bleeds easily. This is there. Whereas this particular one that we are talking about LGV here, no? So this LGV, it is also non-vascular. So one thing is for sure that LGV and syphilis, they go hand in hand. And here also they're going off. And the which fellow like bleeds on touch only? So that is the this dono, dono venosus ulcer. This particular fellow simply bleeds on touching itself. So you call this particular thing what? You also call it as what? Beefy red ulcer, and then bleeds easily. So this particular fellow bleeds easily. Fine. So this particular one, remember like this, it bleeds easily. Which one? We are talking about donor venosus. Fine. And we are talking about the base. Then we have induration. Okay. How much it is hard or soft and all that. Okay. So this particular one is hard, firm, or you can say hard. Okay. You can't tell much about the herpes one. So induration is not there in this. So soft sore. Just now I told you the soft sore, chancroid. So this is soft. Okay. So here only I will tell you one mnemonic to remember this chancroid stuff. Chancroid is caused by what, guys? It is being caused by Haemophilus ducreyi. Okay. And if you take this word ducreyi, in Hindi what you call? Pain. Dukhrai. Okay. So Haemophilus ducreyi, this particular thing is what? It's painful. Dukhrai. So it's a soft and painful ulcer. Okay. And it can bleed. And which like bleeds very easily. So that is donor venosus. That is also termed as what? Beefy red ulcer. Okay. Which is also termed as what? Beefy red ulcer. Fine. Again, the LGV is taking the parts with the syphilis. It is a firm stuff. And here, this also takes their path. This is also firm. And this means what? That is dono. Okay, this means what? We are talking about dono. Here we are talking about LGV. And here we are talking about chancroid. Okay, this is herpes. And here we are talking about what? Syphilis. Fine. So we talked about the induration. And pain, we already have told you that if somebody asks you regarding the pain, so remember this, this is painless. The syphilis one is painless. Okay, herpes ought to be painful. This everybody knows. This will always be painful. Okay, and chancroid, I just told you, dukhrai. So that is very tender, in fact. This particular thing is very tender, very painful, and tender to touch. Okay, so very tender. Whereas lymphogranuloma venerum, this side, it goes into the variable list. It goes into the variable list. But mostly it is, like what you say, mostly it is what? It is painless. Mostly it is painless. But you can keep it in what? Variable stuff. If at all they give very close choices and all, though it can be painful also. So lymphogranuloma can be painful. Whereas donor venosus, this is painless. Donor venosus is painless. Fine. So basically all these are painless only. So painful ones are two fellows, herpes and chancroid. In total you remember like this. And if at all they try to confuse you that lymphogranuloma venerum can be painful also, yes, it can be painful. Okay. And this might be a question to you. Now, talking about the lymph adenopathy, the last point here, talking about the lymph adenopathy. And lymph adenopathy is again what? Painless. Okay. And obviously hard. Okay, inguinal lymph nodes, that question which I have told you now, and it is mostly bilateral. So bilateral hard lymph nodes, painless ones, they are the features of this one. Whereas in the case of herpes, you can see it is firm, it is tender, and it is bilateral. Okay, it is bilateral, guys. Okay, then regarding the chancroid, again the lymph nodes are tender, and in them also the pus can form and they can suppurate. Okay guys, but this is unilateral. Chancroid is only one, this particular disease is only one, so unilateral. So this is unilateral. Whereas in the lymphogranuloma nigrum, you remember like this, that this is also tender. This time it miss out on its favorite companion, syphilis, and the lymph nodes, they are tender here. Tender lymph nodes, painless ulcer. If this is what is there in the question, you're talking about what? Lymphogranuloma nigrum. But remember this, guys, painless mostly, but it can be painful. Okay, so tender may suppurate, this can also have the pus and all, and this is unilateral. This is unilateral. And donor venosus, you have this particular thing, that is pseudobulbos. Okay, pseudobulbos, they are observed up in the case of donor venosus, pseudobulbos. So basically I have made this particular table, and I have made, obviously I know I have made khichdi of it, but I suppose if you go in a sequence and if you remember up that particular sequence of these particular diseases, then it's very easy to remember. Okay, and what is that sequence? You just follow up this particular thing, that firstly syphilis, then herpes, then chancroid, then lymphogranuloma nigrum, and donor venosus. Okay, so how to remember up? Like firstly you write up SH, and then you have the CLD. Okay, so if you go in this particular sequence now, then you will able to remember most of the things. So firstly we had put up the syphilis, then we have put the herpes, and then the CLD. A CLD is what? You can put CLD what? Chronic liver disease, anything. The chancroid, lymphogranuloma nigrum, and donor venosus. So guys, in a nutshell, if you go very fast regarding this, so remember guys, incubation period 9 to 90 days is of what? Syphilis. Then which is having the highest one? Lymphogranuloma nigrum, 3 to 30, and can be 3 to 42 also. Okay, besides this, undermined edges can be asked. Undermined edges is seen in what? It is seen in the chancroid. Then which particular fellow is having the, like this particular thing, which bleeds easily. So bleeds easily is donor venosus. On just touch also it bleeds. So that's why it is having a type of ulcer also, that's known as beefy red ulcer. So that particular question comes. Beefy red ulcer is seen in what? So that is seen in donor venosus. And donor venosus is caused by what? That is caused by Klebsiella granulomatis, which is also termed as what? Calaminobacter granulomatis. Very right. Okay. Then if somebody asks you regarding the pain stuff, because that is also the favorite question of them, that pain is which one? So painless is mainly the syphilis, and this particular fellow, donor venosus, they are painless ones. But LGV goes into the variable region. Herpes, everybody knows it's painful, and chancroids, everybody knows it's painful. Okay, and chancroid is caused by what? Haemophilus ducreyi. From that particular word, you can find out that it's painful or painless, because ducreyi in Hindi, what you called duk raha hai, means the painful. So painful is which fellow? Chancroid. And is it soft or hard, guys? So it's a soft one. So soft, so that is the chancroid one. So remember this also, along with the lymph endopathy, the question can also come. Bilateral ones are which one? Bilateral ones are the first two, that is S and H, that is syphilis and herpes. They are bilateral and they are firm. And this particular one, the difference is, the characteristic feature of syphilis is what? Painless and hard lymph nodes. Whereas the tender one, they are the features of herpes. The herpes is altogether tender. Okay, no point in that. And in fact, most of the lymph endopathies are tender only in the herpes, chancroid, and lymphogranuloma nigrum. But in the case of donor venosus, what you observe pseudobulbos. Okay, you observe what? Pseudobulbos. Now, one or two pictures I can show you, which is there in the Harrison itself. So the first one, you see this particular one. Okay, so this is chancroid. Okay, this is what is termed as chancroid, and you can observe what, guys, here? Multiple painful punched out ulcers. You can see, na, multiple and painful or painless? It is painful, and these are termed as what? Punched out ulcers. They are termed as what? Punched out ulcers. So this particular thing is what? This particular thing is chancroid. Done by what, guys? Haemophilus Tucrae. Okay. Then the second one. This is the typical herpes, and I have already told you everything is tender of it. The lymphadenopathy also and the ulcer also. So this is herpes, and this particular one is lymphogranuloma venera, which is done by what? Chlamydia trachomatis L1, L2, L3. Okay, and in this you can remember up this mnemonic also: A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, and G also. So A is mostly without any feature, so asymptomatic. Then you have in this particular one this bubos, fine. C is Chlamydia trachomatis does it. This is also a confusion among the students, that what does it? So Chlamydia trachomatis does it. What is the drug of choice? Drug of choice is doxycycline is drug of choice. E is what? E is isthiomen. And isthiomen is what? It is a rectal and vulval strictures which are formed up. F is the test for this particular one, and that is termed as type 4 hypersensitivity, Frye's test. And G is a sign which is termed as groove sign. Okay, the G is a sign here which is termed as groove sign. And what is groove sign? That's a groove between the two inguinal lymph nodes. Okay, a groove is formed, and that is made by what? This particular ligament termed as what? Poppet's ligament. Okay, so remember this particular thing, that A, B, C, D, E, F, G. This particular mnemonic tells you regarding the lymphogranuloma venerum also. And what is A? Mostly it remains asymptomatic. B is what? The buboes are there. C is Chlamydia trachomatis. D is doxy is the drug of choice. E is the isthiomen, that is a complication of it. F is the Frye's test, which is a type 4 hypersensitivity. And G is what? That is a groove sign. And you can observe up this particular picture of the lymphogranuloma venerum. And guys, can you tell me what is the incubation period? Incubation period is variable, and it goes between what to what? 3 to 30 days, and it can go up to what? 42 days. Okay, so tell me now regarding lymphogranuloma venerum, painless or painful? Mainly painless, but can be painful. Along with what? Painless lymphadenopathy or not? So that is tender only. The lymph nodes are what? The lymph nodes are tender. So tender lymph nodes is a feature of most of the guys, but syphilis goes against it. In that, what is there? Painless lymph nodes, inguinal lymph nodes. And I suppose these all things and these all different points will help you to remember regarding these genital ulcer diseases. And definitely one question is there out of it. Okay, for sure. And in the next video, we'll take up the lab diagnosis, how to approach up in that. For today, this much is enough, I suppose. Thank you.